thought particles were the hardest, most complex thing ever. But trust me, it is easier than you think. But it's really hard on low-end devices, so make sure you have a PC or something like that. If you have a bad computer, you're not gonna have a good time. Here's the original shot of my hand, and we're gonna turn that hand into particles. But if you wanna see the results, skip to the end of the video.
First, I'm gonna bring my clip into the timeline. I'm gonna compound clip this. So here's what we got. First step is getting a magic mask. We need to mask out the subject so we can remove it later on. All right, now that that's done tracking, let me tell you how we're gonna do this. We're gonna use this mask to do some object removal. After we do the object removal, we make the particles. Then after we make the particles, we have to animate a mask on our subject so the particles can slowly reveal in a really cool looking fashion. To make my life easier, I'm gonna use a saver node and I'm gonna connect the magic mask into that. I'm gonna make a new folder on my computer. It's going to save every single frame in this magic mask as an image. And then I can bring that into Fusion, and that's going to save me a lot of time and a lot of processing. It's gonna make my computer have less of a heart attack when we try to render out the particles. Okay, we're done. Now we're gonna bring in our loader node. I don't really need the magic mask. We can just use this. So now I'm gonna get a object removal, plug the mask into the green input. Everywhere where the red is, DaVinci is going to try to remove it. Yeah, add some blur and then press build clean plate. Forgot to press scene analysis. Yeah, don't forget to press that. After it analyzes the scene, it's going to make a clean plate, which is pretty much a version of the footage without my hand. All right, and there you go. It's not there. Now I'm going to make a copy of our mask. And now for the particles. I'm going to be using a macro called particle fade. And I made it myself, so you can just get it on my Discord server. I'm going to put this onto our timeline like that with the merge node. And now we have some particles. But I don't really like the timing of how it is in the scene. So I'm going to open this up and I'm going to go to a frame where I want the particles to actually appear. So like around, let's do frame 90. And I'm going to use the global in and out sliders right here to make sure the particles come out at that time. Cool. Anyway, we have our particles. They're moving. They're looking really nice. Let's make this actually a part of the scene with the mask. So I want the particles to be coming in from like this direction over here. And I want the particles to kind of just disperse out in every single direction. So using that, I'm going to make a circle mask like this and plug it into both of our inputs right here. Now I'm going to just put this over here where my hand isn't. Go to around frame 70. And then I'm just going to make it a little bit wider like that. I don't want my hand to completely go away. This does not look believable at all. So I'm going to get a displace node. And the displacement map is going to be a fast noise right here. And with that fast noise, we're just going to crank this up. Turn up seethe. Turn up scale. And it's going to make our mask kind of look like this. Let's make it a little bit bigger. More refraction strength. There you go. Now our mask kind of looks like this. That's more like it. Oh my goodness. That looks kind of sick. I'm gonna add a little bit more blur. Actually, no blur there. All right, and this is like the main juice of the effect. Like, we're almost there. So now I'm gonna animate the mask going backwards at around this frame. So now you have a mask animating like that. So now it goes in like that and then back out, revealing my real hand again. Cool. Okay, so I sort of like how my particles look here. So I'm gonna get another saver node and I'm going to save that into a new folder called particles and I'm going to render it. So now instead of my computer having a seizure and rendering every single particle again, it's just gonna put it into the saver node and make my life a whole lot easier. All right, let's make a new loader node here and get all of our particles in place. So now we have a loader node of just the particles. I can disable all of this right here and drag that out the way where I don't need it. And now I can just plug in the merge node right there. So see how this looks so far. What the heck? That looks horrible. Oh, hell no. Bro, what is that? That was horrible.
Brother,
But what happened was the particles actually started out on frame 89 and ends at 251. But the loader node starts at frame 0 and doesn't end at 251. So I have to move it all the way over like that. And that's more like it. It still doesn't really look as good, but that can easily be fixed with a bunch of glow and a bunch of glitches and all types of cool effects on it. Now that actually doesn't look bad. That doesn't look bad. That does not look bad at all. All right, so now I edit the effect RSMB, which adds some motion blur into it. You can also get this effect on my Discord server if you don't already have it. But by the time this thing renders, this is gonna look really good with the motion blur. I just have a feeling. So I'm going to make a change to the mask that's pretty important for this. Notice how the background has the effect of the particles and everything else there. So what I'm going to do to fix that is get a copy of the mask, paste it over here, and I'm going to make that as the mask input for this merge node, which has the particles in it. But now it looks too much like a hand, so I'm going to put a blur on it and crank it all the way up like that. Now, if you take away the hand and put it back, you kind of see how it fills in the gaps there. And in my opinion, it looks pretty nice. I like how this is going. And to be honest, I don't mind stopping here, but I don't think I have enough glow. Goodness. All right. Well, maybe I did have enough glow. All right. Maybe some soft glow. Pretty please. Yeah. Just a little pinch of soft glow in there makes all the difference. And then I'm going to connect the ellipse node into the mask input here, so it's synced up with the animation that we made. Very nice. Let's go. It doesn't have to be too perfect, but just enough so it isn't extremely noticeable. All right, and now we have our particles. Time for this to render, and I'm gonna take a nap.
So you've made your particles, but now you're kind of stuck. You don't know how you're gonna fit your particles into the scene, and something just looks a little bit off. And here's why. There are certain effects that work with particles and certain effects that don't. For my use case scenario, when I first used it, it's because my scene was black and white and it had low FPS. The contrast of the particles was what made them pop and made them look special within my scene. And probably in your case scenario, it's gonna be completely different settings. So, when you're working on your shot and you wanna incorporate some particles, here are some recommendations. First, erode dilate. The erode dilate node is very helpful if you want to control the size of the particles without any lag. You can make them bigger or smaller, you can make them wider, thicker, doesn't really matter, just change the sliders, or you can even use some anim curves or expressions to make the particles look like they have a nice animation. You could also use flicker. Flicker can help the particles have a little bit more life to them. If you have higher FPS scenes, I highly recommend some flicker. Maybe you can make it look more poppy. I don't really know, but it would work. Another thing you could use are masks, specifically soft edge masks. A nice fall off on your particles can make it look really refined and intentional when you put it into your edits. I highly recommend using posterized time with the particles, and all of the examples that I've seen so far, especially from Ikawa and Ugislayer, they've used posterized time or some sort of stop motion effect to make the particles a little bit more defined in a way. I'm not really sure how to describe it, but it looks really nice. Maybe you could cook with that. A combination of all the effects that I just mentioned can make a really nice animation and can add some life into your particles. Don't just put the preset in there and call it a day. Have some fun with it. As long as you have that creativity and you're willing to put some time into these effects, you can really cook up some amazing things. Anyway, my name is Clout. See you next time.